Hello. Hello, everyone. Whoa. That was louder than I thought, slamming my arms down on the table. Hello. Hello.
It
Hello.
started?
Yeah, it started. It's 8 o'clock. Yeah,
Oh,
Meg will be up in a moment. She's putting on her face.
I'll
Oh, Mo's coming. Mo's on his way. Come here, Mo. Hi, buddy. Hi. What you doing, Mo? Come here. Come here. Come here. Hi. Hi. What you doing? Well, he's down here. Trust me, he's there. Oh, there. You can see his tail. He's wandering around. Anyway, hello. Is Ferrari finally suing normal guys supercar? No, that is not what's going on. No, nothing cool like that. It may happen someday. Who knows? Like a cease and desist or something. That'd be fantastic. I don't know. I'll frame it. So, Mousetrap, thank you. Thank you very much, Mousetrap. I'm kicking it off with the, it looks like, is that a hippopotamus in a chair, like leaving rubber, like as he like slaloms? I think that's what's going on. Hello, hello, Redbeard's Racing. Hello, Plum-a-man. Hello, NDPZIT group, Mickey Bang Bang. Where's Meg? Meg will be up here in a moment. She is, she's
Coming.
coming, she's coming. She was just, I don't know, doing something. I don't know what it. Anyway, hello. So, plus fire in the drift. Yeah, there's fire. So it's like fire and tire marks. It should leave like tracks. That'd be cool. I don't know. Anyway, Arizona. Yes. Oh, interesting. So, yeah, it's been a busy week. So, Fred left. Was it yesterday? Yes, yesterday, Wednesday. Fred went home on Wednesday, so he's already home. So Fred is crazy and almost drove straight through. So he drove straight through on the way out here. On the way home, he stopped, he said, for a couple hours. So yeah, it's crazy. Oh, Carrie, I texted Fred and asked when I could call him about car shopping. He's missing an accident action. Fred, where are you? He'll get to you. He's, yeah, I don't
He's
know.
sleeping.
Probably sleeping. Yeah, he's probably recovering. Derek Exotics, I enjoyed your last video on the FCA event. Thank you. There will be another video coming out from day two of that Ferrari event where we went onto the runway. So that's coming out on Saturday. So that should be pretty awesome. The drive tank stuff was very, very fun, just like it was last year. So that's awesome. Yes. Oh, I don't know if S-Line has an exhaust for the F8 yet. I don't know. Maybe they do. Yeah, anyway. Past FCA Indianapolis chapter president has an F12 of about to get his phone number from the current president. Oh, okay. Well, that'd be cool. Go check out the F12. Would you ever wide body your 458? I think it gets asked every single live, and the answer has been pretty consistently no, I will not ever do that to my car. So, yeah. You guys are doing Wine with Dan forever. Oh, Trinidad. Cool. Yeah. Our friend Quentin is from Trinidad. I think you said that last time, and we said that last time if it was the same person. Anyway. I don't know. So tonight I'm actually not drinking wine. I am drinking an amaretto sour because I don't know why. Because I wanted to. That's why. Yeah, this is basically like candy alcohol. Yeah, you pretty much can't taste the alcohol. It's pretty awesome. I'm a fan of it. Rachel Mitchell, gangsta. You're so gangsta, Rachel. Please explain the amaretto sour. Well, you start with the glass, you pour ice in it, then you pour sour mixer in it, and then you pour amaretto mixer in it, and then you drink it. That's it. It's yeah, usually about 1 to 1, maybe 1.5 to 1. Oh, here comes the Megan and the Mousetrap again.
Hello.
Got a new daily ride, 2021 Kia Seltos? I've never heard of that.
I don't know what that is, but I know what a lot is.
What the hell is a Seltos? Huh. Interesting. Saw Tavares vid today. He put a Fab Speed on his Bentley Continental. Interesting. Go Fab Speed. Yeah, Fab Speed.
Fab Speed.
Actually, I do have a Fab Speed. Oh, there's Fred.
Fred, are you awake, honey?
How is he? Did you take like some, did you mainline some serious stuff to get you awake? interesting thing about Fab Speed. So the 430, the 430 project car that we sold. So first of all, I guess I should tell an update on that. So we finally got the title. Yes, we got the title. So that's been taken care of. And we should have payment for the car tomorrow, hopefully. So as of hopefully tomorrow, that thing will be officially sold. It's still in my garage. But I had told the new owner that if he wanted me to do some stuff like put an exhaust or get it tuned or anything like that before it gets shipped out to him, that I would. And so he took me up on that offer. So we are going to get it tuned. Josh actually has the ECUs out of that car right now. And then Fab Speed, the new owner bought a Fab Speed exhaust, and that got delivered to me today. So we're going to install a Fab Speed exhaust. I'm going to do it before, after, and then I'm going to compare it, the 430 to the 458, like side by side, see how they sound, you know, that sort of stuff. So I thought you guys might find that pretty cool. So, yeah, if you happen to want Fab Speed stuff, go to FabSpeed.com.
Fab Speed is now a friend of the channel. Well,
yes.
Fab Speed is now a sponsor of the channel.
They are. Yeah, so the old code NGS15 is no longer valid. You guys bought so much stuff from them that they were like, oh, this is too successful. We're going to tone it down to 10% discount instead of 15% discount. So NGS10 will work. NGS15 is no longer valid. So there you go. Oh, Fred, Carrie, call me in the morning. I'll get you set up. There you go. Yes, we have some side stuff going on there. Hopefully, some cool stuff coming up pretty soon with Fred, and more specifically,
the
Carrie.
Satellite offices of Normal Guy Supercar in Ohio and California.
No, Indiana.
Oh shit! Yeah, sorry, Carrie. Indiana. Have been working together on a new project. So NGS. Indiana and NGS California.
Fred,
updates to come.
Fred got it. Rest up, pumpkin. From Carrie. That's awesome. What are the pros and cons of owning a Ferrari? Pros, it's a Ferrari. Cons, it's expensive. There you go.
Okay, so I've seen like 16 questions for Meg. Thank you.
Oh, Rachel.
Rachel! I ate fajitas with Fred. You know you're just...
That's true.
Dude, the fajitas were legit.
That was some seriously good fajitas. Whoa!
Oh, Mousetrap!
Mousetrap, it's a baby Telluride? Really? Oh, okay. It's like a mid-size SUV instead of ginormous SUV. Like the Telluride. Telluride's really big.
Fred says hi, Rachel. Okay, so...
Yes.
Thank you for whoever said Queen was here. Work is going fine. Thank you. I never wear my hair down except for you guys because it gets in my face. What am I drinking? I'm drinking my go-to, Da Vinci. It's very economical, Chianti from Italy.
It's like $9 a bottle.
It's pretty economical. And I think that was a lot of the questions. I don't know. Lovely. Somebody said they were from Ohio. Get it? That's why I said Ohio, because someone was like, I'm from Cleveland, Ohio.
Oh, yeah, and it just gets in your mind.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, someone, VIP experience, why last live? What's up? Well, it's not the last.
It's not the last of anything,
it's
guys.
Not the last. It just might be the last for a little while. Let's see. It's only 8:09. I'm going to wait a few more minutes to tell that announcement. We'll go a little bit further just in case.
You have to wait for other viewers to catch up in other time zones.
Right, because it's like if I say things too early, then I have to like repeat it like 5 times and it's like, anyway, my drink looks like Fanta.
I mean, it kind of does a little bit.
I don't know.
There's not like an amber colored Fanta. There's like orange Fanta.
I'll tell you what, when I finish this one, I'll bring up the accoutrement to make this drink and make it for you live.
Aw, somebody says they look forward to your Thursday lives. There's, I think I've seen a couple of people say that.
Well, we'll probably still do some occasionally.
Nothing is going away. There are no definites, guys. Uh-huh. Everything will continue to be. But there is an announcement.
I need to make Rachel a
moderator. Yeah, you should make Rachel a moderator.
And moderator. Just because she says things that always get like...
And then she'll just ban her husband.
That's true. F40 status. We are currently on hold, awaiting some financing stuff to get situated. And then we'll continue on. Interesting enough, so since all the F40 stuff started, there have now been two other people that have contacted me interested in buying F40s. And both are possibly interested in having me help them find F40s. So I'm actually going, I want to try an experiment soon. And so you'll all see this soon. Anyway, I haven't totally fleshed it out, so I'm not going to talk about it yet. But I've got some ideas of how to, like, use the situation to the advantage of the channel and to the advantage of my own personal finances. That's where we're at. Orange Tang. I guess it kind of looks like Orange Tang.
Someone said love for NYC. We have a lot of love for NYC.
Sure.
And you guys are going through it right now. So thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if it's thank you. I'm sorry.
I feel like it hasn't moved in a while.
Yeah, is it just like...
Is everyone like just like falling
quiet?
Asleep?
They're like, what's going on?
Someone say something.
Someone say something.
I hope we're
is our feed frozen? Or are people just... What? That many people just watching?
I wonder if the chat's just hosed.
The chat might have frozen. Okay, because usually I'm like responding to things.
I'm going to pop it out and see if it like... Whoa! Look at that. Look how much it missed.
Oh, sorry.
Whoa. Okay.
So chat was like frozen.
Chat totally.
Okay, so let's look at the chat on that thing.
All right.
That thing seems to be real time.
Yeah, sorry.
Why haven't we done that before?
Well, no. Whoa. Hold on. Okay. I don't know what happened there, but like our chat died.
Yeah.
And there was, I popped it out and now there's like a ton of stuff going on. Okay, hold on. We're getting caught up again.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Dan, remind people what's going on with 4:30.
Oh.
4:30 is soon to be gone, though the owner wants some stuff done to it.
Yes.
So it'll be about a week before I get my parking spot back. So owner guy is going to come. I think he's going to ship it.
Yeah, we're going
to the 4:30 is going to the Heartland. Is that location? No. Never mind.
Not the Heartland.
I don't know. Like, what are the barriers of the Heartland? But anyway, 4:30 is going, but it's getting a few things done first. But in the meantime, it's just chilling in my parking spot. In about a week, I'll get my parking spot back.
Yep. There you go. You should charge the owner for parking.
Nah. No.
I can't. It's like, first of all, it's not his yet. It's still ours.
If he wants Dan to do stuff to it, it makes for sweet content.
Mm-hmm. Yep. All right. Yeah. Getting caught up. Sorry. Reading more stuff. Wait. Whoa. Someone said a little bit too infatuated with Dan's wife there, guy. Oh, well.
Oh, it's okay. Leave Harvey alone. He's fine.
Okay. Dan, should I aim for an F430 Scuderia or a 458 in the next few years? Goal setting since I have an F430 now. I'm nervous a Scud wouldn't be different enough. Thoughts?
I don't think it would be different
enough. It's not going to be different enough.
Even I know that, and I don't know anything.
They're great, but honest to God, going to a 458, you'll be like, oh, this is so much better. Like, it's just a much more versatile car, and it can do so much more, and it's faster, and it's more reliable. Why did it block Tim?
Okay, I don't know, because he said the word bitches.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
So just so you know, like, the chat in live is like, YouTube's algorithm is really strict on it. So if you guys curse at all, it's like, holding this for review.
Oh, that's a good point. Someone says, won't the Scud go up in value more? And I
possibly. We don't know for sure. And if that's why you're buying the car, it's a different situation. Like the Scud, like, are you really buying these cars because you care about the value, or you're buying it because you want a car?
Yeah, if you're buying cars for the value, I mean, then why buy?
Yeah, like, it's a different situation. Like, anyway, I would highly recommend the 458 over the Scuderia, considering they're in a similar price point. I think the 458 is far, far better of a car. That's just me. So anyway, there you go. That's my opinion. And, you know, I'm not, that's just me. Obviously I chose buying a 458 over buying a 430 Scuderia. I could have bought a 430 Scuderia and I didn't. I wanted to buy a 458. So there you go. What's up with the Corvette? It is still for sale. We have a possible buyer.
I don't trust it. I don't trust the Corvette buyers. They can never get financing. Why is that?
I think we've had 3 or 4 Corvette buyers fail to get financing. Like, we had a deal and then they couldn't get financing. Yeah. And I'm like, oh man, guys, come on. Like step one of buying a car is like, get your financial house in order. Make sure you know what you're doing.
Oh, people are asking where Moses is. He's sleeping usual around live stream time.
Yeah, here's Mo. There, he's chilling. Yeah, exactly. How can you not get financing on a vet? Like, it's not even like it's an expensive vet.
You can't get financing on a vet. You are a teenager or you made very bad decisions previously.
Probably. Moe Bear.
Oh, yeah. Fred, Mo misses you.
Yeah.
I'm authentically sure he does.
What's your view about putting miles on a Ferrari 360/430 after the 30,000 mark? Already done most of its depreciations? Yeah, I mean, I bought my 430 with 32,000 miles. I sold it with 54 or something like that. I mean, yeah, it's a car. Like, you know, so actually I had a really fascinating talk with a viewer about, he owns a Speciale and he drives the crap out of it. And I was like,
oh, is that the guy you were on the phone this afternoon or yesterday afternoon?
Yesterday and today.
Oh.
And I'm like, man, like, you're a hero. Like, buying a car that's like that, that's clearly worth, holy crap. All right.
Really love watching you guys and learn so much about fixing my car, save so much money.
Well, thank you.
Jesus. Thank you. You clearly save money. That is an excellent tip, sir.
Jeez. Wow. And it's in New Zealand dollars.
Ah! Oh, do you know our friend Kent? Because everybody in New Zealand knows each other. What? Do you know Kent's mom had relations with David Hasselhoff? It has to be brought up once a live stream.
Yes, every live stream.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, getting low on the happy juice. Poor Kent. The clock. No.
We're not totally sure Kent isn't David Hasselhoff's child.
Now you just trying to start bad rumors.
No, it's not. We're just saying the little boy next door that is possibly 1/4 David Hasselhoff looks a lot like David Hasselhoff.
Yeah. What? Yo, it's weird name guy in the house. Oh, yeah. Been a minute. Quick, GT3 or 430? Need to make a decision. I mean, I like the 430 or the GT3 because I think the 430 looks cooler than the GT3 and it's like...
Dan, 488 or Eleanor?
That's tough. Depends. Like, is it like a Super Snake Eleanor? I'd probably do the Super Snake.
I don't know. Fine. Super Snake.
Yeah.
I don't know what that means.
I'd probably take the Eleanor or the 488. But I don't know. The 488's still pretty badass.
Yeah. But Eleanor.
I know. Eleanor.
See, like, we've got this thing. See, I own the Mini Cooper, and I feel like that car really is very much me. And people look at me, and they're like, yeah, I can see you in that car. I don't really, as much as my husband is now a Ferrari person, and his brand is built on Ferrari, I always saw him in that car from God in 60 Seconds. Except not how it is colored in the movie, because it's kind of like that chameleon paint in the movie, which is
it's
weird.
Like gray.
Well, no, it's not like the John Wick gray, though.
Yeah.
It needs to be like John Wick gray, like graphite. Is it flat in John Gray? Like flat gray? Or has it actually got some metallic
in it? It's metallic.
Okay, I don't know. But I see Dan and John Wick's car.
Yeah. Scuderia manual 430. Scuderia, probably. Probably. I don't know. I feel like the GT3 is more collectible. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I'm just not a big Porsche fan. Like, to me, the honest to God truth is when I see a Porsche, they all look the same. The difference is one has a wing and one doesn't. And, like, they've sold so many Porsches now that it's like the next BMW. Like, so everyone in Austin has a BMW and everyone in Austin has a Corvette.
It's funny because they are building the largest Porsche dealership I have ever seen in my life.
Right up the street from us, they're building this massive Porsche dealership.
Several stories.
Yeah, a multiple story, huge complex just for selling Porsches. And it's like, you can't throw a rock without hitting a Porsche in Austin. And I'm just like, it's too boring now. It's like they've oversold themselves and now it's like, they're just everywhere.
Yeah, so, being controversial.
No, I'm just saying it. Like, so, I mean, it's like the GT3 is an amazing version of the 911, but I just see them all over and I'm just kind of like, meh. You know, like when you see a Ferrari, you're like, oh shit, that's awesome. You see a Porsche GT3 and you're like, all right, yeah, it's a cool car.
Porsche people have very clean carpets. What is that even? I mean, it sounds right, but I'm like...
yeah, it's probably true. How about the new Corvette? Give the new Corvette a couple more months, and you're going to see so many of them that it's like the wow factor is going to go to zero. It's like the old C7. When the C7 came out, everyone's like, holy crap, this is so cool. And now you're like, yeah, it's another
Somebody
C7.
Asked me if Nicolas Cage or Keanu Reeves should teach me stick. And I'm actually having a really hard time with that.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
I mean, my first impulse is to Keanu it.
Really? I think you got to go Keanu.
Keanu. Oh, Keanu. I mean, don't get me wrong. I like Nicolas Cage because that dude is not like the rest of us. I mean, he's a little bit like, yeah, unconventional. He's not okay. He's kind of like Gary Busey. But Keanu Reeves is, you know, that's the selfish choice.
Okay, I'm getting a lot of questions of why.
It may be time to indulge the audience now.
It's what, 23 minutes into it? Yeah. Okay. So the primary reason why this might be the last live for a little while.
For a little while, guys.
A little while, okay. Is I had some, or I should say, have an upcoming substantial life change occurring on Monday, which is that I am going back to work. Yay. So I am not, to be clear, I am not giving up on YouTube, but I
won't let him, guys.
No. But clearly, I'm not going to have as much time to do as many videos as I currently do, but I'm going to still do videos.
I am not pregnant, Scott.
So it's going back to work. I'll probably do a video on this at some point in the next week or so, just to kind of like explain a bit more. I am not going to disclose details about that position at this time because I don't want people harassing my job. Or
there's a lot more subscribers now.
So it's just not like I feel like I'm at a point where I have to take a step back to protect my own personal interests.
She's hiding her pregnancy. I'm really not. Yeah. I still have my birth control implant in my arm.
Yeah. Male gigolo again. I hated for this day to come. Ugh. No, I'm not being hired as a fry mechanic. It is in line with what I used to do before YouTube. And no, she's not pregnant. Holy shit.
I am not pregnant.
This is not a sellout.
Oh.
Jeez.
Oh, sell it.
Yeah, because anyway,
babe, they're probably joking.
I know.
Julia, though.
So anyway, that's substantial life change coming back into my life. So am I going to drive the Ferrari to work? No. No. Actually, I'm going to be working from home.
He's working in his office right now.
Yeah, I'm that part of my work doesn't change.
No, Dan's work is that's one of the fringe benefits.
Scott. Y'all, as a friend of Dan's, I can confirm that he is a high paid escort. Scott, you're not helping.
No, I mean just the things he can do. It's an art form, guys.
Yeah. thank you for those of you that are congratulating me. I appreciate it. Dan is pregnant. That's probably a higher probability than and Megan being pregnant at this point. Okay, when is Mo due?
So, my sweet baby.
So yeah, basically, you know, it just was the right time. It was the right opportunity. I had an amazing opportunity present itself to me. And, you know, when you get the right opportunities, you have to grab it. And as much as I love this YouTube stuff, it was not paying the bills at this point. So thank you, Rich.
Oh, thank you, Rich.
Flying dude.
Flying man.
You know, like I've made it very clear that this was not making much money and there was only so much invested money. And so, you know, I got to do what I got to do to keep the bills paid. And unfortunately, YouTube is not going to cover it for much longer. So.
Let's just say during Dan's bohemian artist days that the bills were paid.
Thank you, Rachel.
The bills were paid.
Yes.
I'm a working woman. I'm gainfully employed. I've got my boo.
Right. I like that one, actually. Like, clunk.
Is it with what's prestige worldwide? I can say no. I already know that not to be true, but.
I don't even know what prestige worldwide
is. What is prestige?
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, anyway, there you go. That's the big news. So. Like I said, I'll do a video talking about it.
With a little bit more clarity. But, okay, yeah. So YouTube, normal guy will continue to be normal guy. I predict it will be 2 to 3. This is my prediction as his wife, okay? 2 to 3 episodes per week instead of 4. That is my prediction. And that is about, I think, the extent of the change you guys will see. Because the content is not going to shift. So no. Worry not.
Yeah, I would say it's fair. It's you know, obviously it's going to mean that a lot of the filming for YouTube is going to happen on the weekends. So like right now, like obviously I can work on cars during the middle of the week. I can edit videos during the middle of the week, and that's probably not going to be happening so much. So it's going to be harder for me to get videos out. So actually, I was thinking one of the things that probably is going to happen is the videos will be further from actual time of when it happens. So like, you know, because if I film something on a weekend, I probably won't be able to edit it till the following week. So it probably might be like a week and a half or 2 weeks before it gets out. So things might get delayed a bit. Am I still going to pursue like these project cars? I think so. So this project car, the F430, was successful enough. We made some money on it. That it makes sense
and
to pursue
as soon
them.
As the owner of the 430 in my garage gets it out of my garage, then Dan will certainly do the follow-up video explaining like the autopsy of the finance and how much money was made, and the person who sent him the link for the car will get their 1/3 of the profits.
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Peter.
Thank you, Peter. Little fat rolly guy.
I mean, someone says 2 to 3 episodes a week with a full-time job, but Dan was working full time prior to YouTube and putting out 2 or 3 episodes a week.
Yeah, it was hard. So that's, I mean, you know, that's.
I don't know if you guys know my husband, but he's kind of an intense personality.
Thanks. Yeah, well. So you're going to be a cam couple? No.
I mean, aren't we already?
We're just not. Cool.
What's a cam couple?
I'm assuming it's like probably like a porn thing.
That's gross. No.
That's my guess. I don't know. What's taking so long for the F430? Like I said, it was all a title issue.
It's a COVID thing.
The COVID slowed down us being able to even get the title. So obviously his financing company isn't going to give us money until we have the title. We just got the title a few days ago, or it might have been last week, but I think it was Friday. We got the title finally. So now his financing company is verifying the title. They're going to send us money probably tomorrow, and then we can finish up with the 4:30 and get it out of here.
Oh, dude, Rachel wants to cook this weekend. Yeah. I mean, that's a sure thing. Whatever you're making, Rachel.
It'll probably be good.
It'll probably be great.
Yeah. Pretty good. So, yes. I'm excited for Fred and the F40. Hell, yeah.
That is a thing. That's still happening. Still a thing.
That is still happening.
But it's like, you know, buying a 430, I mean, excuse me, an F40, excuse me. Everything's a combination of letters and numbers. It's like Elon Musk's new child's name that California wouldn't even let him name. Hello from New Zealand in the future.
Woo!
We got
a couple of New Zealand people.
We've got a New Zealand following.
It's all because of Kent.
It is. One of us lives among you.
Do you think it's possible to find another F40 under a million? Yes, it's not easy though.
I don't know if you want to buy them.
So here's the problem. We found a few F40s under a million, and from kind of what we concluded, you don't want the F40s that are under a million. They've probably been beat up and need some work, and you're gonna end up paying
Difference?
Yeah, it's like the big joke about Ferraris. Whether or not you find any Ferrari. Thank you, Mousetrap.
Thank you, Mousetrap.
Find a Ferrari, find like the general price for that Ferrari. And if you find one that's like, you know, two sigma off on the price, you're like, you're going to pay that same price anyway because it's going to need that much work. And the same thing with the F40.
Oh, someone's in Hawaii. I'm so jealous.
Yeah, that'd be.
God.
That'd be nice right now. Less COVID to deal with, too.
Well, yeah, they're like totally buttoned up in Hawaii, right? Yeah. You can't even go there.
Yeah. No, we're not giving an F40 to, kidding me, to the Wizard or Tavares? No. No.
Yeah, no, I don't think Tavares needs an F40 from anyone.
Oh, give a bad F40 to, yeah, exactly. They can deal with it.
Well, Tavares would be the one to look for the bad F40, wouldn't he?
No, it's the other guy.
Wait, I thought Tavares bought Burt things. Doesn't Tavares buy stuff?
Yeah, he bought the charred.
I don't know.
355.
I don't watch any of these channels. I only hear snippets about what their general theme is.
Yeah. F40 equals Ferrari part only. Not sure you mean. Oh, money. Yeah. The monies are. Yeah. It's really crazy. Are they just high in mileage? No. It's not because they're high in mileage. Like, usually if they're cheap, it's because they have missing history, sketchy history.
Oh, thank you, Dan.
Thank you, Dan. Is that a cup of. I don't know what that is, but we'll give a cheers to that. Clank. Y'all better start drinking. We have been.
Oh, way ahead of you there.
Dude, this is like number 5 tonight.
Don't say that.
I'm doing good tonight. I'm feeling it. I've been having, it's a good Thursday. Barbados.
Dude, that's cool. The homeland of Rihanna.
What? Really?
Yeah.
I don't know these things. I don't know. Anyway, like I said, I'm almost done with this. I may have to reload this drink.
How about an Audi R8? Because nobody wants an Audi R8, bro. Iron Man wouldn't drive one. That totally ruins those movies for me. Excuse my language. Iron Man or Tony Stark would never own an Audi R8. Why would he own that? If anything, he's going to be driving the, like, what is it? The top-end Ferrari, like the special.
LaFerrari.
Yeah, LaFerrari. But even then, it's like, no. If he's not driving a $5 million hypercar, why would a man who designs his own super suits drive anybody else's car? He would have, like, a flying car he built. It's, like, weaponized. But if he's not building his own, he is driving one of like the top end hypercars. There's no way he's driving an Audi R8. I'm sorry. I feel very strongly about this. There we go. I let it out.
You went serious on that one. You're like, no.
I really did.
No, Tony Stark doesn't drive an R8.
No. And even though I don't like Ben Affleck Batman, I kind of like his gull wing Bruce Wayne car. But even better than that, of course, because Ben Affleck Batman is awful. Awful. Christian Bale drove the, what's the Lambo?
Oh, he drove a Murcielago.
Which means bat,
which means
right?
Bat.
Of course he did. That Thank
was,
you.
Which was brilliant. That was brilliant. So, yeah. Just tuned in. What's new? Changed. Oh. Well,
oh.
Yeah. See, there.
Yeah, I see people always showing up late.
Yeah. I think I need to reload my drink. Where is your next vacation going to be? Oh, thank you, Mousetrap.
Thank you, Mousetrap.
You're way too nice today. Oh, dropping the mic. We have a few ideas of the next vacation, but we're leaning most towards going to Florida, possibly like the Fort Myers area.
Or Sanibel.
Or Sanibel Island.
I love Sanibel. I'm going to be honest, guys. Flying international right now, this isn't the best year for that.
No.
And so we're kind of thinking about driving and where can we drive in the continental U.S. that we would really like. It's either go to the ocean in Florida somewhere, which I really miss the ocean, or it's go north to like a beautiful lake house and whatever. But it's really hard for me to not be near the ocean if I have that option. Plus, we get to bring Momo.
Yeah.
So Moses would be able to come on the beach with us. It would be really awesome.
Carrie, you're not listening to me. USVI, baby. The big thing is we're not sure.
It's not like I don't want to go there, Carrie.
The big thing is we're just not sure about the flight thing. I don't know if we want to step on a plane right now. You know, that's kind of our fear. So yeah, that's kind of like.
Oh, Mousetrap, Colorado is gorgeous, but I'm not like the mountain climbing girl.
Well, plus we go to Colorado a lot.
That's true.
And I have family there.
And so do I. Yeah. We have certainly been Colorado.
So, yeah. So we're kind of like, I don't know about Colorado. So I should reload my drink.
Okay. Plus, if we go, you can go. I'll answer Meg questions, yeah, whatever ahead. Those look like.
I'll bring up the bottle.
So oh, Lordy. Okay. So, yeah, if we went to Florida, because I think Dan has a sizable Florida following, then you could come see us. If I trust that you are not a serial killer. And then, you know, you could do car review stuff with Dan, whatever. I know there's a lot of normal guys in Florida. Being that the last time Dan drove through Florida to pick up a car, some dude in the panhandle in the middle of the night in a weird truck stop restroom freaked out and fanboyed on him and was like, oh my God, you're a normal guy. In the middle of a bathroom in a truck stop in the middle of the night. It was a thing. Miami, Florida. It's all about Destin. Kent keeps mentioning Destin. I really love Sanibel. I really love that part of Florida and the Gulf because of the shells. The shell game is where it's at, guys. Hey, Sean. Did somebody say, I don't know what a GT3 is. I know that it's a Porsche and it's probably a higher end Porsche because you guys keep talking about it. And if it's yellow, I don't want anything to do with it. I mean, you guys understand. I'm just not – in no universe am I spending that amount of money on a car anyway, but, a yellow supercar? No.
I'm very sad. I was almost out of mixer, so.
Yeah. Well, he's working on that.
I had to make, like, a half glass.
What about the Tesla?
No. It's not the same thing.
I mean, I like my Mini for me, guys. I like my Mini Cooper for me, guys. This has never been about Meg's, like, normal guy, like, or normal gal supercar. That's not what this is. This is normal guy super. This is Dan's channel. And I'm just here to provide the uninformed, disinterested perspective on occasion.
Meg needs a YouTube channel. Believe it or not, we actually have the Dan and Meg
YouTube channel. We have our, like, our home videos, like, our travel, like, vacation videos on another channel.
We don't publish that very often.
Yeah, we used to publish them on the same channel before the channel grew.
Yes.
Oh, Mousetrap.
Are we getting...
Fine. Rachel can teach me to drive with a stick. That's fine. Ruin our friendship. What's a mini GP?
It's a even like sportier version of the mini than what you have.
Have I even seen it?
No, because they don't make very many of them.
It's like you have to be invited to buy it mini?
No.
What is it?
You gotta like... Yeah, it's hard to get one.
Oh.
Turbo the Mini, it already is. It is turboed. Anyway, So yeah, so we're thinking about Florida as a vacation spot, probably. That's so you can drive there, bring the Mo,
Bring them all.
go sit on a beach and get drunk. Sounds great to me. Yeah, that sounds pretty good.
That sounds
Have
lovely.
we been to DC? Yes.
I've been to DC like 10 or 12 times in my life. I love DC. I love Foggy Bottom. I love the brownstones. I love sitting in the little cafe where JFK asked his wife to marry him. I love them.
What's the most expensive bottle of wine you guys have drank?
Probably, no. Probably the one in London at that one restaurant we went to. Oh, the name of the restaurant was, it was actually French, I think it was La Bouche, which means like the
The
mouth.
mouth, yeah.
And we bought this stupid expensive bottle of wine. It was in Kensington.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember how much that was. Was it like two something?
Yes, it was ridiculous. Or and that's in
Well, I would say that's the
pounds.
most expensive we've bought. I was at a business meeting.
Thank you,
Thank you, Sean.
Sean.
Thank you very much. I was at a business meeting and someone ordered a bottle that was like $1,000 or some crazy crap. It was like,
He's like, really?
and like, I was like, all right, it's good, but I don't know if it's $1,000
If I
good.
was the boss of a company with discretionary spending like that, I would fire that guy for buying a $1,000 bottle of wine. But anyway, have you been to New York? I've been to New York two or three times. Dan, have you ever been to New York? That's weird. Well, we're not going right this particular minute, but he will get there. Have
Yeah.
I ever been to Boston? I have not been to Boston.
Never been to Boston or Philly, like the Upper East Coast. Nope. Kentucky, oh yeah,
Dan has been to
lots
Kentucky.
of
That's where
times.
Moses is
Yeah,
from.
I went to Kentucky to pick up Mo. Come to Chicago. I
We've been
mean,
there
we
about 30,000
yeah, we
times.
go to Chicago a
We got
lot.
engaged in Chicago.
Yep, we did. We got engaged in Lake Point Tower in Chicago. So, no, my sister lives in Chicago. We go to Chicago a lot.
You need to visit Argentina. I would love
Been to
to.
Minneapolis, New Mexico. Never been to Argentina.
I want a tango.
Frederick, Maryland. Nope, haven't been
I have
there.
not been.
I've been to Maryland,
I've been to Maryland as
but not,
well.
I don't, well, I don't know where Frederick is.
What is it? Some place called like Chevy Chase or Bethesda? I've been to Bethesda.
Yeah.
Chevy Chase is a part of Washington, D.C., but I've been to Bethesda, Maryland. Okay, yes, Meg and Dan have been places.
Post.
Haven't been to Post, Texas.
No.
No.
How far south have you been in the Caribbean? We've been a lot of places in the Caribbean.
Yeah.
I don't, yeah, a lot of places.
We've been to a lot of places there, been a lot of places in the South Pacific. We stopped through Amsterdam the last time we were flying through Europe because we were on our
Yep.
way to Tanzania.
Yep.
And we stopped in Amsterdam just about a year ago.
I feel like I've been to Marfa.
I haven't been to Marfa, but it's supposed to be such a cool Texas hippie town.
Yeah, I don't know if I stopped in Marfa.
Are you both happy you bought a Ferrari? Like, I don't say that I'm happy. I think I've made peace with it, and I didn't buy it. I reluctantly finally gave in. But yeah, I would say I'm acceptance with having a Ferrari in the garage. Dan is probably very, very happy. So on average, if you average acceptance with supreme happiness, yeah, we're both happy.
Is that what it is? It's
Yes.
like minus two plus 17.
If you, if the average of Dan's euphoria for owning a Ferrari with my reluctant final like making peace with it, like then the average is
Oh,
happy.
I just remembered I had a glass of that crazy expensive
Oh, the whiskey stuff?
no, it's like a cognac or not a cognac, but whatever it was,
You know it's gross?
The
I'm sure it was.
Louis Trey, whatever, it's $3,500 a bottle, and I had like one glass, and it was wasted on me. I don't like that stuff. So anyway,
If you guys ever want to hear about the story of Dan buying the original Ferrari, the F430, just go back in our videos. And there's videos of me.
bitching about it. Yeah,
I think my points were really well made,
I'm
actually.
not saying they're not.
I don't think you qualify those as bitching. I think you qualify that as just really good points.
Yes. Lubbock, good time.
Get your guns up, Lubbock. Pew, 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 pew.
There you go. Panhandle cities. So I suppose there's some people that probably have arrived. We should probably go over.
Okay, give it a review, Dan.
Yeah, because it's been like another 20 minutes. Okay, so if you arrived in the last 10, 15 minutes, the reason for this being the last live for a little while, it's not the last ever, just the last for a little while, is that I have a new job and I start on Monday. No, I am not giving up YouTube. I am just slowing down on YouTube. So obviously my job will take high priority over YouTube, and YouTube will become much more of a secondary thing. So that's kind of what is going on in my life. Don't bother asking who or what or whatever. I'm not talking about it in detail at this point because I'm trying to kind of take some of my personal life back.
Oh, Eric.
Thank you, Eric.
Thank you.
So I think in a weird way, I almost think I went too far and gave too much access into my own personal life, which, not that I don't like all you guys, but there's been
Megalodon.
It's been some weird stuff, you know, so I want to regain some of that.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Just now he decided that in the last 18 months, be like, we're going to be reality stars. And I'm like, really?
What have been the main drawbacks of starting a YouTube channel? Do you got an hour?
I think Dan has on the whole loved it. And okay, so we're talking about it in the past tense, but Dan's channel isn't going anywhere, guys.
Yeah, it's not going away.
As I said earlier in this live stream, my prediction as a spouse, knowing my husband to be a particularly intense personality, even if he's working full time, I predict y'all are consistently going to get 2 to 3 episodes per week, as you were the last time he was working full time.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's a thing.
Yeah. Thank you. I appreciate that. I am looking forward to my new job. I'm actually very, very excited about it, and it's a great opportunity. So I had to take it. Yeah. Would you say there, what would you say is/are the keys to success of your marriage to one another? Complete animosity.
Right. It's a sham marriage.
It's a sham.
It's a sham. I'm a beard.
I don't know.
Or Dan's my man beard. I don't know.
I mean, we just get along.
We get along very well. Well, we do.
And we like.
I don't think it hurts that we both have similar backgrounds. I think that sure. There are big components of our backgrounds where we relate to one another.
I also think like we both retain our own independent lives.
That is absolutely true.
Like, I feel like sometimes married people like intertwine too much, and it's like your entire life becomes one and neither of them have like their own things. Cause like there's times where I want to go play with cars and she's like, I don't want to be near a car. And so she does her things and I do my things and we're both happy. So anyway,
we have thank you, Bubba.
Bubba C.
Someone says big age difference. And in fact, that is not what's going on here. Dan is 3.5 years older.
Yeah.
3.5.
So, yeah.
Yeah, no, I do think we communicate well with each other.
Yeah.
I would say that is a big deal.
Very honest and open about a lot of stuff. Like,
and I'd say, you know, okay, as a mental health professional, I could go a long time talking about the things I think we do right and the things that we actively try to avoid. But I do think we're good communicators with each other. And it's not like that came like instantly. God knows we've been together for 20 years, so that's a learning process. But I do think we have a good line of communication.
Who's the coolest in the marriage, Dan, Meg, or Mo? I mean, Mo, by far.
Oh, I'm not that cool, guys. I'm really not.
What are your thoughts on the FF? I mean, I personally like them. I think they don't hold value for crap, but they're cool. I like how chilled you both seem to be. Chill.
No, I don't even, like, okay. So I don't know how to describe myself. I think with each other, we are chill. I think people think because this YouTube channel exists that Dan is an extrovert and or I am an extrovert, and quite the contrary. Dan is an introvert. He's just slightly less so than me. I am not shy, but I'm a major introvert. And just because I have no problem expressing myself doesn't mean that I'm outgoing, because I'm not, believe it or not. And I think anybody who actually knows me will attest to that.
Tim, Meg isn't chill. She is super passionate about what she believes in.
That's true. Let's not talk about what I believe in.
Yeah, we're not going to go there, but yeah. It's true. Colorado drives Pike Peak. I've been there, done that. It's cool. It's good stuff. I'll probably be out there at some point.
I'm not going to trade in Dan. He's going up in value now. He's at perhaps the bottom of the market, but now he's in the vintage category. So, you know, now he's a car as an investment.
Thanks. Have you ever been in a street fight, Meg?
No.
Can we have Meg talk about her views on people of the Fry forums?
I have very few cultivated views about people on message boards in the Ferrari world, because I've never actually been on any of them. There was one incident with one video. But no, I think my thoughts in that video were well said, in that I think those people are just way too into their thing.
Yeah. I would tell you that I think the Ferrari message boards are just super hit and miss.
Well, I think
there's
some
really great information and there's some absolute BS information, is kind of my feeling on it. So you got to take it all with a grain of salt. Yeah. If you haven't seen that Wine with Meg video on the Fry Farm, watch it. It's brilliant. I've rewatched it multiple times.
Oh, yes. People like that one.
Congrats on getting a job running the F-chat message board. Hell no.
Yeah, no. Dan is now a full-time developer for nothing. Never mind. I don't even want to say it. I don't want to invoke it.
Yeah, it's not worth it. There. Keep them coming.
Okay, what other questions, my peoples?
Yeah. Got some more questions. How does Meg feel about vaping despite the health risks?
I can provide, I think, a relatively succinct answer. I think vaping in the long term, although the evidence base is not out on it, and frankly, it's not healthy to inhale anything besides air. I think in the long term, my speculation is that vaping will constitute harm reduction in comparison to cigarettes. This is my guess.
There you go.
Those of you who are in addictions professionals or mental health professionals, you can say what you want. I think in the long term, when there's more longitudinal studies of vaping versus cigarette use, that the vaping will constitute at least less poor health outcomes and overall harm reduction compared to cigarette use.
Do I deal with SQL? I mean, I know SQL. I know it very well. Rumor has it Dan's editing Doug DeMiro's articles on AutoTrader.
No! That's not happening. Somebody said a channel for Meg and Coral and Cooper S content. That would do horrible. There's like three guys who are like, yeah, it's about Mini Coopers and Coral. I'm there.
Any more content from the weekend rally? Yes. Saturday, I will have the part two of our little Ferrari Club adventure out to the Drive Tanks place. Oh, Monster.
Okay, then we have to.
Please tell the beginnings of the relationship, how you met. You're going to tell it?
Okay, I can. Okay, we get asked this a lot. Okay, so
I'm going to take a nap.
So about 20 years ago, I was 16 years old, and Dan was 20. And our friend, who was between our ages, Becky Ringle, she was 18. I snuck out the fire escape in the basement of my parents' house, because basements are a thing in Michigan. And I got into Becky's Sebring, and we drove off to the main street of our town in Kalamazoo, and the main street was Westnich. And so we stopped at a little restaurant called Pizza Square, where all the boys, local boys with muscle cars, stopped to park in between driving up the main street of town. Because
cruising.
And Becky introduced me to Dan in that parking lot at Pizza Square. And Pizza Square doesn't exist anymore. And then pretty much after that, Dan and I were rarely apart.
Sure. Yeah.
I mean, what did I miss? Mm-hmm. What did I miss?
Oh, that's fine. Okay. There you go. there you go. So, Dan's new job is consulting firefighters on how to cleanly put out fry fires. yeah. Date night at Sweetwater's Donut Mill. No, we didn't go there the first night. But
the first night, but plenty of times.
Yeah, sure.
We always went to, yeah, everybody in Kalamazoo went to Sweetwater's.
Sure. Are you looking forward to the Maserati Grand Coupe successor? No. I'm sorry, I'm not. I don't really. It's not like on my radar as a car I care to own. There you go. Meg is strong. If I smoke that much, I'd be on the floor. You know, it's not.
Let's be clear, guys.
This is just like regular
nicotine
vape stuff.
It is nicotine.
Yeah. Yeah. So we've been together for 20 years. Best meal you've ever had.
And there's a couple that come to mind.
Yeah, there's some really notable meals. I don't know if one is like the best.
Dan, both of us love Chateaubriand with Bernays sauce.
Like the night we got engaged.
Yep. Dan proposed to me in this really beautiful restaurant in a very high floor in a building on Navy Pier in Chicago. Lake Point Tower. And it was beautiful, and we had Chateaubriand and Bernays sauce. Mm-hmm. There was also a little restaurant in an island called Tiaman off of Malaysia that just had this amazing fish with the fried rice. I had it like six times. Some really wonderful meals in all the major cities we've been in. Certainly everything we ate in Rome and Italy.
Oh, yeah.
The Amalfi Coast was fabulous.
That last night in Rome, we had those fillets out on the street. And then they came and they gave us like that shot of liqueur that you hated.
Oh my God, it was awful.
But like that was a really good.
Of course, you know, everything in Italy is memorably good food, right?
Yeah. Yeah. My pulled pork. I do make some good pulled pork. Yes.
Dan does make excellent pulled pork. I don't know if you guys know.
Yes. What's one thing each of you that after 20 years together, the other doesn't know?
What
is something that like each of us doesn't know about each other?
I really don't think there's that much.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot.
There really isn't that much. I mean, because guys.
Sometimes I'm pretty sure she knows me better than me.
No, I'm sure I do.
Because she'll be like, "That's not your belief system." And I'll be like, "Shit, you're right."
Live your values.
Yeah, yeah. Man. That's what she says to me. Live your values. I'm like, oh. Why do you have to say that?
Yeah, I know what underlying he really believes in. When I think he's doing something contrary to his character and his belief system, I kind of tell him.
No updates on the failed header ceramic coating stuff at this point. I pinged the company today. Their insurance is being slow as crap. So
of course they are.
Basically, I'm going to give it like a couple more weeks and then hire a lawyer. So... Because, well, I'm going to have to. It's like $5,000.
That's true.
It's not like, if it was like a grand, I'd probably just be like, whatever, we're done. Just walk away. But, like, it's not that I'm going to sue the company. I'll have to go after their insurance.
Yeah.
I just want to be done with it. I just want the money and then be done with
it. Is Dan into sports?
Nah.
Not really. Oh,
Matt
thank
Sherman.
You, Matt Sherman.
Thank you. A little smiley
yeah,
face.
Yeah, Dan did, like, competitive.
Cycling.
Well, no, you did do that. When that was in his 30s. He did a lot of, actually, competitive amateur cycling. But when he was a younger man, I mean, in high school, I think he did really bad on the golf team in his high school. And I think he skied one year.
I was on the ski team. Yeah. That's when I broke my thumb.
Yep, I remember.
It still kind of creaks this day. Yes. Take a shot for the last stream in a while.
Oh, shots are gross.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
I didn't really have anything to shoot. And I guess we got tequila.
I'm not shooting anything.
But we don't even have like a line.
You can go and shoot if you want.
I don't want a shot.
I don't want to do that.
Oh, God.
What are, I mean, yeah, like we're old people with jobs now. And I'm not boring. That old.
We're boring.
But no, it's just like, I don't want to do shots. Like, that's not fun.
It's painful. Shotgun some Bud Light seltzers. I don't even know what a Bud Light seltzer is.
Is that like White Claw? The claw's the law?
The claw. What bike did you ride when you were cycling? When I was road riding, my last bike that I still have is my Pinarello FP3. So I've got like 35, 36,000 miles on my Pinarello. Yeah, there you go.
Dan really gets into things. I don't know if you guys know that.
Just do a keg stand. Oh, God, we're going to just get rid of that one right there.
Okay.
Yep. Move.
Peanut butter whiskey.
That sounds horrible. Gross. Yeah. Yeah, I'll just tell you right up. If you do political views, I'm going to ban you.
No.
This is a car channel. It's a car channel. If it's not on one of my videos, we're not talking about it. We don't talk about politics. We don't talk about that crap at all, ever. Just don't go there. Appreciate it. Shimano or can't be Shimano. Yes, Shimano. Meg's hobbies. Dan, remember me took you and your friend over to CNC when you were Alan Kelly? Yes, I do remember that. That was fun. We saw a lot of cool cars there. That was fun.
So when I was by my hobbies at the current time, I love my job and it is also my hobby, but no, I like fish tanks. I don't really have a lot of hobbies. I'll probably develop some when I'm not as involved with my work, which who knows when that'll be.
Yeah. People ask great questions.
Well, yeah, people are very.
Favorite thing about the drive tanks weekend? I mean, the runway is just so much fun, but I will say it's the unique experience of driving a tank is pretty badass. Rachel, if budget was a factor, new mom car idea.
What's a cool mom car, Dan? We should do an episode on that.
What cool car can you get as a mom?
Oh, dude, and Rachel would have to be featured in that episode because she's the only one with the informed perspective.
That's the problem.
Like, how do we do an episode on that? We don't know.
I can't help a mom find a car because I'm not looking at any of those features.
You helped Megan House buy the minivan. Well,
but she already knew what she wanted.
Yeah. You just helped her negotiate.
Yeah, yeah. She was like, I want this minivan. I said, great. And I said, I'll help you get it for cheaper. And that's what we did. But I don't, like, she was like, this is what I want to have. And I'm like, okay, cool. We found it. Here it is. Like, I like fast AF. Yeah, C63 AMG.
A Ferrari has a wagon.
Yeah, you could get the FF or the Lusso. That would be pretty.
They can, you know, those are.
That would be like straight up pimp mom car.
Yeah, it would.
You'd be like, screw all you other moms. My shit has 750 horsepower.
It's a four-door.
Actually, I really want to get a hold of one of those, and then we should take like Kent and Rachel and have like everyone in the car and just go bombing down the road.
That would be fun.
That'd be fun.
We could put two car seats in it and be like, yeah. I mean, you could review like a mom.
Yeah, you could throw
you
some
car
seats. You
put two car seats in that car.
Yeah. On a scale of 1 to 100, how loud was the tank firing? It was stew loud.
Stew loud is really loud.
It's one of the loudest things I've ever heard. But even more than the loud is the concussion. Like, you feel it. Like, it pushes you. And you can feel it thump your chest. And then the heat and the intensity. Yeah.
It's what's just, a Unis?
Urus.
Oh.
It's a Lamborghini SUV.
Oh, Lamborghini has an SUV.
There you go, Rachel. We can get you the Urus. That would be pretty
Why
bad.
Did they have to name it Eurus?
I don't know. It's a terrible name. Yeah. Fart can loud. The Piero Sanje, yeah.
That's a pretty name, Piero Sanje.
Piero Sanje.
Piero Sanje.
You know what it means?
What?
Pure blood.
Lame.
That's the new Ferrari SUV that's coming out in 2 years, which is going to cause me to, like, as the one guy said, it's going to cause me to eat my own gun.
What, the Corvette guy? That's going to mid-engine next year. Oh, yeah, I'm going to eat my gun.
Yeah. I feel like men would be very critical of a Urus. We need an empathetic car review of a Urus.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, if I can get a hold of one.
Somebody supplies the Urus, I'm happy to review it.
Yeah, we'll probably start, hopefully, like, we can start doing some car reviews.
We will be cautious, but as things reopen, as long as it's safe to do so, we can probably do more car reviews, Guy. I mean, the car reviews are we've been holding off on those as a function of, like,
try not to get sick.
Respect for human life.
Yeah.
I'll put it that way.
Oh, yeah. Tariq might get one.
Oh, yeah. There was somebody in Austin.
A
friend of the channel.
Yeah. A friend of the channel wrecked his Lamborghini Huracan this week in one of the bad rainstorms. He hydroplaned and spun it out and hit a wall, and it's like, oh man, that's never a good day. So thankfully he was totally okay, but the car is not looking so good. It blew the airbags and stuff, so it hit pretty hard. So that sucks. Perhaps I'll find it on Copart next month. You might, absolutely. If you see
it'll be on Tavares's channel.
Yeah, if you see a Huracan with a big giant Marines logo on the front hood, that is his. Did you sell a Corvette yet? Nope. Corvette people are the world's worst people when trying to buy a car. They're the number of tire kickers trying to buy that Corvette is just like mind numbing. I can't believe how many people just, and they're all, literally every single one of them doesn't even make a reasonable offer. They don't even they just all give you a lowball offer. That's all they're doing. And the thing is, strategically, it makes sense because there's so many Corvettes that, you know, eventually someone's going to be dumb enough to go, yeah, I'll take your 25 grand. It's like, what? Anyway, there you go.
Is Corvette stick? Dan's particular Corvette is stick.
Yes, mine is a stick. What happened to that silver Boxster? It's gone. We sold all of the Turo cars.
Well, Loper didn't sell his.
Well, he kept the Maserati.
Yeah.
Because he loves it. So the only two cars left are the Maserati and the Corvette. Everything else is sold. So Trackhawk review. I could review Travis's Trackhawk at some point.
It's a fun SUV.
Yeah.
As SUVs go, that one's fun.
Yeah. I don't know why we bought the Boxster. I can't remember.
Because you guys did market research and the ones that were running out the best included the Boxster.
That was like the third best, I think.
Yeah, that's why you guys bought it.
No, the Porsche did better than the Boxster. The 911.
I was going to say they're both Porsches.
The Corvette was number one, Jag was number two, the 911 was number three, the Boxster was number four.
Okay.
There you go. As far as number of rentals and how much money they pulled in. So. We'll wrap it up at
Someone asked, when will your 458 change the clutch disc?
When they die.
When do they generally die?
They last a long time. You don't even hear about it. They last so long. Well over 100,000 miles. So, yeah. It's a different clutch system. It's a wet clutch. So they don't wear like a normal clutch. They last a very, very long time. And it's dual clutch. So you're, like, even without it being a wet clutch, you have two clutches. So they're wearing at half the rate of a single clutch. So you figure if the 430 single clutch wears at 40,000 miles, that means you have two clutches. It shouldn't wear until 80,000 miles at least. And it's a wet clutch, so it lasts way, 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 way longer. So, yeah, you're probably going to get, like, 200,000 miles on a clutch on a 458. So you don't really have to worry about it. Yeah, I saw that stupid Huracan for 180 whatever thousand miles for sale, and it was way overpriced. It's like, give me a break. They wanted 130 something thousand for it. I was like, give me a break. Yeah, load of crap. Don't buy that car. That's my advice. Will you get a 48 in the future? I don't know. I can't predict the future.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I'm going to wrap it up at 9:15 tonight. So five more minutes.
Five more minutes, guys. Ask Dan your questions.
Yeah.
What's burning? What's on your mind?
Yes.
Before I hop in my bath and watch documentaries.
Yeah, and fall asleep.
Which is my usual routine.
I'm sold to 4 of 8. Do it.
I will say, as an observer, a lot less fixing of things has seemed to go on with the 4-5-8 in comparison to the 4-30. But that might also just be a function of age. Is that a function of age, or is that a function of there's just more things sorted on the 4-5-8?
Both.
Both? Okay.
Yeah, it's both. But mostly, it's more sorted.
Oh, someone said, which documentaries? Well, thank you for asking me questions about documentaries. I started a 7-day free trial to the Smithsonian Channel last night because I saw it. It looks sweet, and all these cool documentaries were on it, and I couldn't access it without the Smithsonian Channel. And then I woke up in the middle of the night. Dan had to go to the restroom, and like he literally woke me up to tell me, what the hell is the Smithsonian Channel? Why do we have a membership to it? They're just going to start charging us when the free membership ends. And dude, I swear to God, woke me in the middle of the night, tell me he was canceling my free Smithsonian Channel subscription.
You were already awake.
It was free.
No, but for 7 days.
It was free, Dan.
7 days.
And then I could have watched more cool documentaries, and then you could have canceled it.
You still have it. It doesn't cancel it until the 7th day.
We shall see.
It does. It says so in the email.
Well, I last night was watching a documentary on the early history of the HIV virus and just how far back the origins actually went. And we're talking like HIV is probably 100 years old. And it didn't start to appear in the... Okay, anyway. So...
where is Mo? He is right over there asleep. That's funny. Tim. We worked on Tim's 348 today. So we got that sorted, and there will be a video coming out on that probably sometime next week. So look forward to that. It should be good. Yes. Last questions. Come on, get them in. 2 more minutes, and we're calling it good. Where's the documentary in the Ferrari factory? Oh,
hell. I don't know.
I don't know. Smithsonian Channel is tied in new diary. Oh, man. People come up with interesting stuff.
Minis with scissor doors.
Have I driven a 599? No, I have not.
Dan is not quitting YouTube. Oh, guys, this isn't even close. Dan, okay, so for those people who just tuned in an hour and 13 minutes into this live stream, for the 6th time in summation, Dan's not quitting anything. He has taken a wonderful employment opportunity, which means he will just probably do a little bit less YouTube, guys. And I say for the 3rd time, it's probably going to be this is my observation as his wife and my prediction. It'll be 2 to 3 episodes a week instead of 4. And that is the difference you will see, is my prediction. So, Dan's not quitting anything.
All right. Oh, yes. We already mentioned the clock. We already got that out of the way.
Did somebody ask about the clock?
Yeah.
Show them the clock, Dan.
I should
show them the clock just so they can see.
There's 1 minute left. It's like, here's the clock.
Oh, who wants the clock? It's the clock everybody wants.
No one's getting the clock unless you want to give me $500.
Yes. PayPal, $500 to Dan and I, and then we will send you the clock.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Maybe. I might just keep the money. Okay. That's going to do it, I think. So, yeah.
We adore you guys.
Yes, thank you for joining us for these Thursday night drinking sessions, and they've been very fun.
I think they've been good for everybody when we've been isolated.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'll try and see if we can't squeeze them in here and there. Probably not for an hour and a half.
Good Lord.
It's a lot. And then also totally just going to depend on how my new job kind of pans out. So certainly not going to happen the first few weeks because I'm going to be working a lot of extra hours just trying to get educated on my new stuff. So, yeah, I have a lot to learn in the next coming weeks. So I'm going to be very busy with my new occupation. So anyway, good night, everyone. I really genuinely appreciate all of you for hanging out with these things. And
there's plenty more car stuff. It's going to be sweet, guys.
It will.
It will. I'm certain of it.
All right. Good night.